In order to solve a rational equation as we see here, we want to multiply both sides of the equation by the least common denominator or least common multiple of the quantity x minus 2, the quantity x squared minus 4, and the quantity x plus 2. When we do this, we will eliminate the denominators, producing an equation that we can then solve. So to identify the least common denominator, we first want to make sure all the denominators are factored. Notice x squared minus 4 factors into a difference of squares, so we can rewrite this as the quantity x plus 2 times the quantity x minus 2. And now looking at the denominators in factored form, we can see the least common denominator would be the product of x plus 2 and x minus 2. Which means we're now going to multiply both sides of the equation, or each fraction, by this product. Now we're going to rewrite the original equation, but we're going to leave a lot more space horizontally. And now we'll multiply each fraction by the LCD, or this product here in red. So we're not obtaining a common denominator, we're multiplying each fraction by the LCD over 1. And again, the whole point of doing this is it will eliminate the denominators. Notice here we have a factor of x minus 2 over x minus 2. Notice here we have a factor of x plus 2 over x plus 2, as well as x minus 2 over x minus 2. And then on the right, we have a factor of x plus 2 over a factor of x plus 2 that simplifies to 1. Now notice all the denominators are equal to 1, so we've eliminated the fractions. Now we'll determine the products. Here we have x times the quantity x plus 2 plus, here this product is just x. And on the right, we have the quantity x plus 3 times the quantity x minus 2. Now we'll clear the parentheses and solve the equation. So here we'll have x squared plus 2x plus x equals, here we'll have x squared minus 2x plus 3x minus 6. Now we'll combine like terms, we'll have x squared plus 3x equals, on the right side we'll have x squared plus x minus 6. Now it looks like we have a quadratic equation, but notice if we subtract x squared on both sides, the x squared terms simplify out, and we're left with a linear equation, 3x equals x minus 6. So let's go ahead and subtract this x term on both sides. This will give us 2x equals, this is 0, so we have negative 6, dividing both sides by 2. We have x equals negative 3. Now there's one more important thing to remember about rational equations. Remember, division by 0 is undefined. So when we have variables in the denominator of the original equation, we need to be aware of which x values we must exclude as possible solutions. Notice if x is equal to positive 2 or x equals negative 2, we would have division by 0, and therefore these values must be excluded as solutions. And since our solution is not one of these two values, our solution is valid and correct. Okay, we'll take a look at another example in the next video.